Hi, welcome to an Arduino tutorial from Robojax. My name is Ahmad Shamshiri. I'm presenting this tutorial from Canada. In this tutorial, we are going to see how we can use this BH1750 Light Lux sensor to measure the lux or intensity of light and display it on serial monitor. On this one, it is written 662K. The range would be from 1.2 to 5 volts. And SDA, these two pins are connected. You will see the address change to 0x5C. This line is initializing the I2C communication. You can get the code for this by clicking at the link below the video in the description, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. Let's get started with this. When you purchase the module, you might receive it like this with a pin header. There, this is actually BH1750, that's the sensor. And this is the BH1750 data sheet from ROM Semiconductor. Measure between 1 to 65,535 lux based on I2C communication. The maximum operating voltage is 4.5 volts, so that's why we have to regulate it to 3.3 volts. VCC typically is 3 volts, and supply current is 120 microampere. This is a voltage regulator. This is 662K, and here's the datasheet XC6206. This is a positive voltage regulator. The range would be from 1.2 to 5 volts. Maximum current is 100 milliampere, typical. It can be used for many purposes. The actual sensor is very tiny, and I've put here a voltage regulator that you can feed in 3.3 volts or 5 volts, so it can adjust it and bring it back to 3 volts nominal for this device. So in both cases, it can work. And then we have VCC and ground, and then we have SCL and SDA. These two pins are for I2C communication to get the register value from this device. And also we have another pin here, address. Using this, if you connect it to 5 volts, you can have a secondary address of 5C. The default address for I2C for this module is 0x23 or hex value of 23. Let me now explain the wiring. If you need the wiring diagram for this, you can get it from my Arduino course at Udemy. If you want to learn Arduino, I have a bestseller course on Udemy where you can learn Arduino from ground up with hundreds of projects, all course material, library, codes, wiring diagram, everything available in one place. The link for my Arduino course is below this video in the description. Here is the wiring. VCC is connected using gray wire to 3.3 volts or 5 volts. In both cases, it will work. Ground is connected using purple wire to the ground. SCL is connected using blue wire to A5. SDA is using green wire connected to A4. You may also connect it to SDA and SCL at this point. It will work fine. Let me now explain the code. First, you need to download this library of BH1750. I will provide it as a zip file you can download, or you can come to this link which I will provide you and then click here, clone or download and select download zip. Once you download it and saved it as a zip file, then on Arduino IDE, click on sketch, include library, add.zip library, and then point it to where you have saved it. For example, if it was inside PC, downloads, tutorial, and if this was the library, select it and click open. This will include the library. Make sure to close Arduino IDE if you have multiple. Once you are done, click on file, example, and then BH1750 and open this test. And this is the code. Include wire.h is for I2C communication. It is included by default as part of Arduino IDE. This is the library that you have just included and downloaded. And from this class, we are creating an instance. We call it light meter. Inside the setup, we initialize the serial monitor with 9600 baud, and this line is initializing the I2C communication. The only important part is this 9600 baud, which must match here when you click on serial monitor, and at the lower portion on this side and the lower side, it must match 9600 baud, and then light meter.begin is initializing the setup for the light sensor, and this will just print it inside the serial monitor. Inside the loop, light meter dot read light level, and this will give us a float value which will be stored in a variable called lux. And here we are printing it. This is just a text, and this is also a text. So this is our value, and we are waiting 1000 milliseconds or 1 second, and then the loop will continuously reading the value. If you want to take some action or do something based on amount of light, you can do so. So you can say if lux is, for example, greater than 500, then this condition, if this condition is true, then your action will be between these two open and closing parentheses. And here, put the action, whatever you have. So let's say turning on a light or turning on a relay or whatever you want to do, do it here. Here is the demonstration. The code has been uploaded. The module is facing up, and here it shows, if I don't move it, it shows around 2530 lux. And if I bring my hand over it, it shows about 59. Or if I cover it fully, so it is around 54. I have another light here. If I point it the other way, 2300. Let me turn the lights off. The top light is off now. It is 721, and if I face it towards the light, 900. So the amount of lux is shown. Now I'm using my phone by turning on the flashlight. Let's see. So 10,000, 14,000. Around 15,000 lux. And here, if I put it properly, no, 54,000 lux. So this device can be used in many applications. So for example, for solar application, for to track the solar panel, and also so you can use it to determine the quality of different bulbs and put it in a fixed position and put the light in a fixed position and replace the bulbs and measure the amount of light and amount of energy. This way you will know it. Perhaps I'm going to do a video about that. If you do not connect this ADDR pin and upload the code, and here I've uploaded this I2C scanner code I will provide you. You just copy and paste it in a sketch and upload it. After that, if you just open it, if you open the serial monitor, you will see that it reads the I2C address to be 0x23. And according to the data sheet, this is a binary value of address when it is low. When it is not connected, it will be 23. 0100011. And here, if you convert this value that you have here, this 100011, if you convert it, you will get the hex value of 23. And here now, if I connect this, if I connect here a wire and connect it to this 5 volts or 3.3 volts, doesn't matter. As soon as I connect it, you will see the address change to 0x5C. And if I remove it, you will see that it will change on the next reading, 23. So 0x5C. And look at this here. 10111100. And as you can see, the hex value is 5C. This is the 5C, and if I go to binary, that's the binary. So this is the hex value when you connect it to 5 volts. Thank you for watching the tutorial from Robojax. If you like this video and learned something, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. If you want to get updates of my upcoming videos, make sure to subscribe. If you want to learn Arduino, I have a bestseller course on Udemy where you can learn Arduino from ground up with hundreds of projects, all course material, library, codes, wiring diagram, everything available in one place. The link for my Arduino course is below this video in the description. Actual sensor is very tiny, and I've put here a voltage regulator that you can feed in 3.3 volts or 5 volts, so it can adjust it and bring it back to 3 volts nominal for this device. So in both cases it can work. And then we have just two wires. We have VCC and ground, and then we have SCL and SDA. These two pins are for I2C communication to get the register